come on.
Dipset. Yep. Get on the grind like clockwork. Move that behind like clockwork. Keep it coming on time like clockwork. Get that clockwork. Make that clockwork. Sound of the tick tick. You hear the sound of the top. You hear the sound of the clock.
And get it right.
Yeah. Move to the sound of the tick tick. Move to the sound of the top. Move to the sound of the clock.
And get it right.
Talk, yep, yep. Now let me see you get that blockwork rolling. Let me see you get that clockwork going. Fiends copping by the clockwork flowing. All day and all night till them SWAT cops rolling. Or that clock stop going. Tick.
What's up? It's your boy Big Mate. A lot of y'all know me as Mike, but first off, this is off the clock sports page, and it's gonna be a really good tribute to a friend of mine that I didn't play with while in high school, but I played with afterwards. And y'all know him as Terrence Mitchell, but everybody know him as Jug. RIP to the king, and we're gonna miss him. But I want to give out a couple little things that I, you know, a couple stories that I, you know, met him through. I met him around 94. I heard about him in 88, 89. I was at Marshall as a freshman, and they were with, he was playing with East with a couple of names, H-Man, Reg, Barley, are a few names, and mostly I know him, you know, forgive the mind, man, but don't blame the heart, because I definitely got love for everybody that played, that's been a pillar of the basketball community that we have in Rochester. But this guy particularly, man, showed me why he was different than a lot of players that's coming out or came from Rochester that made it. As all y'all know, I always say Jug and a good friend of mine, Trent Jackson. So, you know, him and a couple other people who I've always said, you know, was like really, some people that I admire to play with or wanted to play with or just watch. And Jug was one of them dudes that you just had to watch. One time, I had to move back to Syracuse like in 91, 92. And he was going there. I think that's when the time him and Tony Scott might have been up at Syracuse. I saw him going up the hill towards the campus near the hospital. And I saw him, and he didn't know me. But I said, hey, Terrence Mitchell. I said his name, and he looked at me like, who was you? And you know, we went back and forth and told him, like, you know, da-da-da-da, here it is. And we got to know each other. So we started playing a couple games up in Syracuse, Kirk Park, near Lemoyne College, on the campus of Syracuse and stuff like that. So a few years later, moved back to Rochester, and we started playing. So around, like, I want to say 2001, we used to play at Jefferson Middle School. This janitor used to let us in the gym, gave him a few dollars or whatever. And I'll never forget, I can't remember the white kid, but this is the reason why I say Jug is different from a lot of players playing on that basketball court. If y'all ever played against him or with him or watched him, he always dribbled wide, and like he would just like get out my way. Like he didn't really give a fuck. And that's how he played. So we playing at this gym at Jefferson, not outside, but inside. White kid, like, respectable, never trash talked, didn't celebrate the, you know, to piss you off. He made a shot, he just went down and da-da-da, whatever. Jug was the type of dude that said, I don't give a fuck about this dude at all. Elbow him, push him, follow him all hard, and whatever, dude get up, don't say nothing. Like, yo, Jug, what are you doing? You know? Like, man, I don't give a fuck, man. Like, he said, fuck that nigga. I'm like, he's white. He's like, man, fuck that nigga. And he played like that. And the reason why I say that, to say this, and if y'all played against him or watched him play, he played with a great foundation of this. I'm going to deal with the pros and cons of my game. I'ma be the same person. I'ma deal with the success and failures of my game. Cause one thing I wanna do, I wanna beat your ass on this court. Off the court is a totally different thing. And that sometimes is a switch that some players that y'all see nowadays don't have. You know what I mean? And I don't know if that's just from the old school of playing because they had Rizzo. I don't know if that was just, you know, that time in the early or the mid 80s to the late 80s from Chris Tuck and them guys that was at Charlotte that was being coached by Coach Jones. I don't know if that was something that spurned in them or whatever it was, or just, man, just straight confidence. Man, that dude was just like really, like, different on the court. You know, we call him the Jordan of Rochester when it comes to basketball. And, man, to see him, you know, move on in the next phase of, you know, I don't know if you're spiritual or religious or whatever, move on to the next phase of, you know, of just him not being around. I ain't gonna never forget that dude because, you know, I'm never was top player in Rochester, but like my uncle, a lot of players respect me because I played against a lot of them. You know what I mean? I played against, you know, Carl Jefferson, Rick Norris, Carl White, H-Man, Reg, a slew of players, John Wallace, just a lot of players from Cobbs Hill to the Y, even through high school. So, you know, it's just, you know, one of our basketball guys, man, it just, you know, he's moved on from us, you know, and I want to send out a real big condolence to his family, all the friends that we all was touched by his game, and even outside of that, you know, because, you know, he used to live off of, I think, Fairbanks off of Hudson. And he would always come down to where I actually live at, and we would just kick it, you know what I mean? And, like, really on some basketball, other things, so it wasn't always just one aspect, like, oh, yeah, I remember this. It was just, you know, good to talk to him and then, you know, kind of look at it. So, with that being said, man, forever my king, man. Terrence Mitchell, you're going to be missed, a.k.a. Jug. Smooth.
Get on the grind like clockwork. Move that behind like clockwork. Keep it coming on time like clockwork. Get that clockwork, homie. Make that clockwork. Sound of the tick tick. You hear the sound of the top. You hear the sound of the clock.
And get it right.
Move to the sound of the tick tick. Move to the sound of the top. Move to the sound of the clock.
And get it right.
Talk, yep, yep. Now let me see you get that block work rolling. Let me see you get that clockwork going. Fiends copping by the clockwork flowing. All day and all night till them SWAT cops rolling. Or that clock stop going.